Learning to grade your videos without using LUTs or qualifiers is super important, especially if your videos aren't the best quality. Don't worry if you're just starting out, this method is great for beginners. We'll be using DaVinci Resolve and you can learn this technique in just 2 minutes. If you like using LUTs, that's okay too. I'll show you how to use them in the right way. Let's get started.
Now, the secret to unlocking pro-level colors lies in one fundamental step that most people miss entirely, setting up color management properly. So in DaVinci Resolve, you're going to come down here to this cog at your bottom right corner. You're going to come to your color management. I've set my color space to DaVinci YRGB. And my timeline color space, we're going to use DaVinci White Gamut Intermediate. And for the color output color space, we're going to use Rec. 7 Rising. This will give us the maximum flexibility that we actually truly desire. Now that we have color management set up, there's a quick but essential node-based transformation that will make a huge difference in how you interact with your colors. Here, we're going to add one more node to this node tree. You can either come by adding here, come here, add nodes, add serial node. You can see Alt S. So you come to your effects tab here and then you drag and drop the color space transform here. So since we're using Blackmagic Raw, we're going to select our input color space as required. We're going to use Gen 4.5, and for our input gamma, we're going to use Film Gen 5, and that should be okay. Well, you could come back here to the next node, which is second node here. You can drop another color space transform, but something I prefer doing is to use Alt, drag and drop. This way, everything I've done on the first node gets applied to the second node, and then we can click on swap. The reason why I left the input color space input gamma empty and same thing here, output color space output gamma empty, is because I'm trying to make it like a timeline workflow where we're imputing to the timeline's color space. We're bringing the camera's information into what we are working in DaVinci Resolve, which is our DaVinci Wide Intermediate, which is a very wide color space that we can work in. So for our output color space, we're going to go to Rec. 709 and our output gamma is going to be gamma 2.2 or 2.4. I'm using 2.4. So, and then we can label these clips. Let me just quickly label them OCT, output color transform, same thing. We can copy this grid to the remaining two Blackmagic Raw clips. The first clip is a Blackmagic Pixies. This is Ursa Cine 12K and Ursa Cine 12K. Now we are moving to organizing our nodes for exposure, balance, and contrast to make sure each color adjustment is precise and controlled, giving you the maximum flexibility. We're going to be creating 4 nodes. One for our exposure, balance, contrast, and then an extra node. By pressing Alt S, you have 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to label them accordingly. So for exposure node, all you need to do is to actually look at your waveform here under your scopes. Your waveform is going to be something like this. Select waveform, another vector scope. You want to ensure that all this is turned on, zone 12, skin tone line, show crystalline, and then under here you're going to ensure display qualifier focus is on, so that when you hover here it will reflect on your vector scope down here. We're also going to come here and click on show RGB values so that you can see the RGB values of whatever we're going to use, which is going to come in handy later on. So for your exposure, the bright way to do your exposure is to do it in a linear space. We're going to do our exposure under global, just something basic. We're going to leave this to around like maybe like a 1.5 to a sort spot that I feel is good to really stretch out the image and get the fullness out of it. We're going to right click on the balance node and we're going to change our gamma from use timeline to linear. And then we're going to come back here to our primary reels and we're going to use our gain to adjust this just to get it in a sweet spot. To be honest, it's actually fairly balanced. As you can see, the skin tone is actually lying in the exact center. So there's really not much we have to do. Maybe I could sway it just a teeny tiny bit to the right, just a bit. Nothing much. You can see that little swing. Beautiful. So for our contrast node, since we're working in DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate, we're going to change our pivot to 0.336. And then that way, when you adjust your pivot, it moves around the middle gray. So you can adjust your contrast to kind of stretch the image and make it look sumptuous, if you get what I mean. You don't really want to crush the blacks or the whites. Just give it a little bit of depth, if you get what I mean. Adding the perfect amount of teal is about knowing exactly where to make the adjustment in your footage. Most people skip this crucial step. In our look node, we're going to come down to our primaries and then we're going to drag our lift and our gain only towards our teal region. So our teal region is usually around here. Ideally, I kind of do mine in a much more mathematical way, which is I come down here and I subtract down to, I increase this to like 0.05 like this. And then I do the exact same thing for this guy so that I have like a very consistent teal drag towards this side. And then the same thing I do here, I move this to maybe around like 0.1. So this will be around like 1.10 like this. And then you can see it's already looking good, which is from here to here. But then this is not enough. Perfecting the blacks is a tiny tweak, but it's one that makes a massive difference. If you miss this, your colors won't pop. On the same node under your look, you can do it on another node, but I prefer doing it on the same node. You go to your log wheels here under your primaries, and then you basically just want to subtract, because as you can see here, remember what I told you to turn on show RGB values. Originally, the hair is somewhat around black, as you can see, it's fairly black. So you want to subtract that by coming here and you're going to try and subtract that. But then since we did it in a mathematical way, which is like we know the values we did, we could kind of like guess it by like subtracting, like let's say we could do -0.05, something like this. And then you do the exact same thing for this side, -0.05. Mind you, the 0.05 here is not the same as the 0.05 here. But then let's just subtract it that way. And as you can see, it looks much better. So you see the before and after, it's looking good. You can as well scroll down to get more, but you don't really want to crush the blacks. You just want to make sure that they look reasonably good. Now, as you can see, even though the look is looking nice, we are kind of closer to our teal and orange as we actually desire. But as you can see, the skin is messed up compared to where we were before. So we want to fix that. And how you can fix that is by actually either right clicking here and saying, add a parallel node, or pressing Alt P. And then all you simply want to do in your parallel node is to come to your curves. So under your curves, you're going to come under hue versus saturation. That should be the third one here. And then all you want to do is to first of all click on red, then you're going to click on the skin tone, exactly how I said it, red, then click on the skin tone. Then you can left right click here, this dot here, that's what you're going to raise up. You're going to be very smart with it. You can't really take it that high. But let's say we're going to, I usually keep it around like 1.4. So as you can see, 1.4 is a bit strong. Just, see, it's a bit strong, but I think it's okay. So you come here and then you raise your reds. You raise your reds. So you're going to raise your reds and try and see a way to smooth out. As you can see, her skin is kind of breaking at this point. Oh, no. Her skin is kind of breaking at this point, so you don't want that. So you're going to try and use that red to kind of smooth it out. Can you see? So it seems like we're packing at around like 1.2 something. So let's say like 1.25. So that was before and after. And you can see that's a very drastic change. But then if you pay attention to the skin isn't still correct, because if you remember originally, if I turn this off and you put your eyedropper on your skin tone line, the skin tone is sitting or around this quadrant here on the skin tone line, and that's not what we're getting. So you can look at this part of our cheek and our forehead, they are both on the skin tone line. So if you turn our grid back on, even though our skin is looking much better now compared to before, we're still on the skin tone line. So we're going to come here under hue versus hue, we're going to click on red only, and then we're going to come here and click on this. This is going to generate something like an editable spline. You're going to raise it up and drag it to this side. So you're going to play with it. So if you raise it too high, you see what happens. You're going to take it down, like very close to the bottom, depending on the skin tone you're actually dealing with. And then you're going to cross check that. Okay, now, is she there? Yeah, she's almost there, almost. So you're going to try and take her closer to where she was originally. And as you can see, just that little change, if I undo this, can you see control, you see? Night and day, night and day. And now if you turn this all off, before, after, starting from here, boom. And this, my friends, is a masterpiece. Now the beauty of this grid is that you could actually apply it to any of your other clips. Let's pack it around here. If you right click and apply grid, you can see it's kind of blown out. But let's first of all turn off this look, and then let's address everything for what they are. So we're coming here, reset our contrast. And the reason why I'm not doing reset node for all of them is because remember, I changed the color space of this one And for this one, I set the pivot to 0.336. So, but you can reset this one. So now the image is fairly good, but then we're going to kind of like step it down just a tiny bit. If you turn on the look, I guess it's looking good, but it's not looking good. So we're going to come down here and step the exposure down to like maybe a minus one. But I was actually thinking like maybe like a 0.5, a minus 0.5, something like this. So before, after, just a nice step down so that you have enough room for exposure, be able to drag your exposure up and create that beautiful sumptuous contrast here. So you see, and now from here, we're here looking good. I think her skin tone is really balanced to some extent. I want to move it down a bit, so let's do that. Under our gain, we can just move it down slightly. Yeah, so see, just the blue tint, we're moving it, removing it, and making it much more of a balanced image generally. Good. So now if you turn on our look, okay, and I'll do the subtraction, and you can see how beautiful this is, my guy. I can't be the only one seeing this. Like, on a more serious note, although like obviously the skin tone is slightly off, so we can come here and just hold this editable spline and maybe move it up just a tiny bit so that she falls back on the skin tone line. So you just tweak it and it's looking good. Like, oh Jesus, I don't even know what to say. Like, this is where we came from. Okay, we came from here and now this is where we are. Boom. Like, it's night and day, I'm telling you. See, boom. So once you come here, turn on the look, boom. Oh my God, boom. And then the beauty is you could actually just come here and save this node itself. You could come here and save it however you want to save it. So, I mean, it's reusable. That's the beauty of this whole thing. It's reusable. Bro. Oh, God. Me, myself, I'm even feeling this great. Like, bro. Like, oh, Jesus. Hey, whoa. Oh, my God.
Wow.
Now imagine if I said you could do all that in just one node, and you can even fine tune it with sliders. Introducing this free DCTL Tetra, link in description. Bam, 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 bam. So now let's delete these nodes because we obviously do not need them anymore. And let's create a new serial here. We're going to come here and then we're going to scroll down to DCTL and drag and drop that here. The DCTL we're looking for is Tetra. And now all you need to do is basically looking down here. You're just going to play around with your sliders here. We're going to scroll down to the white red section and then we'll scroll down. And then we need to fine tune the green so that it's very much similar to how, like the angle of teal and orange, you understand what I'm saying? Something like this. I mean, you fine tune it however you please. And as you can even see, the way things are moving, the skin tone is still looking fairly reasonable, and I'm pushing it. I mean, I'm pushing it, bro. See, the skin tone is still intact. It's still intact. Can you see that? The skin tone is still intact. Now, obviously, some people argue that, oh, the skin tone is not really as intact as you're reclaiming. So you can just come back here and then just tamper with the red just a bit. Tamper with the red. You see, I'm swaying things around. I can push things, manipulate them how I please, before, after. See that? And then because, as you can see, it's having this, like, you need to separate it a bit more just to make there to be separation, so you could increase your contrast just a tiny bit. Increase your contrast so there'll be much more separation, you feel me? So then you come back here to your DCTL and then you can tweak things around, maybe actually reduce the red and just play around with the green. Because that's what I want to subtract. I want to subtract the green and the blues that we added to the skin and just narrow it down so that it focuses on the right spot. And just like before, we'll copy, and this time around all we have to do is just to basically copy the node. Let's rename the node label. Let's call this Tetra. Yeah, as soon as I've done that. But yeah, Control C, come down here, let's delete this too. Alt S and Control V, Tetra is in. So similar to what we did before, let's find a sweet spot that we like, maybe like here, and we come to Tetra, play around with the skin to ensure that her skin is in the right position. I want to raise her skin up for more separation. Oh, Jesus. I want to raise her skin up for just a little bit more separation and then tweak this boy this way to make sure she falls under that category. And then, like before, you increase the contrast so that everything pops out of the screen. So before, after, you see that? Oh, wrong, sorry. Before, after. I mean, like, day and night. If you want a separate video on the installation and usage of the DCT, I'll leave it in the comments and make sure you are subscribed to get notified when I release the video. While LUTs can transform your footage in seconds, there's a right and wrong way to use them, and most people miss out on the full potential. So at the end of our OCT, we're going to add two more nodes. We're going to call this one, we're going to rename this one and call it Cineon Film Log. I mean, Cineon Film. I'm just going to call it Cineon Film. And then what you're going to do here is you're going to add another color space transform here. Boom. And then this one is going to be from Rec 709 to Gamma 2.4. And then you're going to go Rec 709 again. And then you're now going to stop at Cineon Film Log, like this. And then here you're going to now right click and add your LUTs. You're going to add the default LUTs in DaVinci Resolve. Under Film Looks, you have this one. And as you can see, it looks good. Before, after, you can see that it adds that oomph into it. So you now have version 1, version 2, version 3. All having three different flavors of teal and orange. I mean, what more can you ask for, my G? Looking good, bro. Looking good, my guy.
Now that you've mastered the cleanest way to grade teal and orange, there's an advanced trick that Samsung users can use to leverage and take this even further. Samsung users have a hidden feature that adds depth and color range, perfect to creating cinematic images. Click here to learn how to unlock your footage in DaVinci Resolve and build on the skills you've already learned.